I'm extremely thankful for the whole opportunity, even though I didn't win it. You know what I mean? I'm thankful to be going out there and, you know, being able to go ride with top 14 cowboys in the country. You know, I didn't really realize until, like, when we all pulled in there to the ranch that I was the youngest contestant in the whole deal. I had the oldest pickup and trailer, and I had some of the youngest horses there in the whole deal. I didn't feel like I had to prove anything while I was there, but after watching the final production, now I feel like I have to prove that I'm not a kid, because that's how, come to find out, a lot of people thought I was just a kid.
Cowboys, you're currently standing in the Laramie Mountain Range. Now, in the movie The Man from Snowy River, Jim Craig is able to herd dozens of horses through rough terrain when no one else can. And today, you'll be doing the same thing.
What I remember from when we gathered the horses on that challenge, well, right off the bat, once we got the horses held up in there and they started milling around, you know, that paint mare, you know, and I'm on the opposite side of where that paint mare broke. So I didn't see what was going on. But then after watching the episode, if I wouldn't have said Diamond, I guess I would have had to have said Buck, because that horse went right by him.
That's it!
One black and white horse takes off right past Buck, and now the herd is following it in the wrong direction.
And then, basically, I mean, it went as good as it could have gone. That paint mare kept trying to run off with the herd. All I remember is that I walked up to Diamond and said, "Hey, Diamond, we might want to send somebody ahead to open those corral gates," because I remembered them being shut. And that's when Diamond kind of snapped at me.
"Hey, we need somebody to get to them portables and get them center gates open."
"All right, Steven, if you want, take the lead. Since you're after it, go on."
"Okay. And Diamond, I think they have
you help." "Go ahead, Kevo, you got it."
I have nothing against Diamond. I think he's a good guy. I think he's a good hand. I just, right then and there at that point in time, it seemed like, you know, he automatically had the thought in his head that I was some young, done, fast, go hard all the time, no methodically look, thinking about things. And that's not how it was.
"So whose fault is it that you were almost 30 minutes longer than the blue team, Steven?"
"You drop a man off in his hole, he fills that hole. You know how many times that boy was out of this hole today? I can't count that many."
"He told me one time to stay in my hole."
"No, sir."
"I hate to say it, and Diamond, I got a lot of respect for you. I think you're a good leader. But honestly, I think that part of the plan was what got us."
You know, at the end of the deal, whenever he went home, everybody told me to go hide in the kitchen because he was mad. Like, and they were worried that something was going to happen. And I just wanted to be able to still shake his hand, you know what I mean, and say, "Hey, man, nice to meet you. Like, I hate to see you go, but, you know, it could have been any of us, you know what I mean?" And I did. I did go out there and shake his hand. I left the kitchen, and he said, "Fair enough," and we shook hands, and everything was fine, you know what I mean? There's nobody I have anything to badmouth about anything.
In today's elimination challenge, you'll be camping out and watching over your herd.
My strategy at that point in time was to do whatever job I had to the best of my ability, because to be honest with you, I haven't been camping since the Boy Scouts when I was like a kid, you know what I mean? Like, I can't tell you the last time I went and pitched a tent, you know? And I just knew that there was gonna be a lot of work that needed to be done, and that I needed to keep moving, you know what I mean? And keep doing something. And that's like whenever they got me saying I was working, you know, that's because I was, you know? I mean, Jamon and Sal started out on the cap sitting there overnight, and we built two fires on each side of the herd. And then Sal was gonna switch with Buck at midnight, and then the plan was that I was gonna switch with Jamon at midnight.
Nobody's been here on my side to help me, nobody.
Steven would have took your spot, you could have slept too.
No, you need to pick up the slack when you see somebody's in a bind.
Jamon, respect to him, I talk to Jamon quite a bit. He wanted to stay up with the cattle all night long, and I tried talking him out of it. And he's like, "No, man, I'm anxious." He says, "I want to make sure and be responsible for something." He's like, "I'm going to watch these cattle all night long."
Who did a job all night?
You didn't have to, Jim.
Oh, my gosh. How do you figure that I didn't? Because I didn't see anybody get on their horse.
All you had
hang
to
on,
say...
Hang on, hang on. It's not a matter of saying, dude. Like, you were tired, right?
Yeah. Okay, so what makes you think that I'm not tired? Or he's not tired, or he's not tired?
Why would you make it a one-man band?
It's not a one-man band, dude. This is supposed to be a team effort.
So I guess if the only thing I could have done differently that I think might have changed it besides on and roping that steer the next morning would have been telling Jamon, hey, you need to switch with me at midnight and take a break.
Jamon, you wanting to go rope is...
Sure will. I go rope, but my horse got used pretty hard last night. I don't know.
Well, I can hang out here and, you know, Jamon and Buck, you guys gonna go catch him, and then me and Sal will take care of camp and make sure the cows stay.
All right.
I regret not volunteering to go rope that steer in the morning, or them two steers, because I didn't switch with Jamon all night long, and my horse didn't get rode until that morning. Yeah, you know, I think Booger's the one that pointed it out that I should have went and roped that steer, and I should have.
You stood at that camp all night. That man didn't get off his horse. There's four of y'all. How could you not swap out? You got to see action. You know, when them boys went to rope, you were fresh. You was the freshest man out there. You might have carried wood, but the best thing y'all could have done is rotated your time.
Stephen Hyman, you talk a lot, but I mean, the truth is you didn't get on your horse one time last night, and you didn't go rope this morning. So, Stephen Hyman, you're done here. Gather your personals and hit the trail. Appreciate it.
Yes, sir. You know, since the show, I mean, I've been going nonstop. I'm no longer working for the Freeman Ranch. I went out on my own, and I've got my own shoeing business now. I got Heitman's Farrier Service running full steam ahead right now, and I'm still day working and helping out at a few local ranches all out here in southeastern Colorado. And I picked up a couple jobs auctioneering at the local sale barns and just kind of hanging out and doing the best I can and making money. That's all I can do right about now. I've finally just come to the contentness of I'm glad with what happened. I wouldn't have changed it any other way. It already happened, and I'm just super happy to have been able to go up there and do that. But the entire process of learning how reality TV works and meeting these guys and getting to do these kind of challenges and be part of this, that's probably my favorite part of it all, is just being able to have the opportunity.